selections for you this morning. Laudate Dominum a cappella by Tomas Luis de Victoria, and it's arranged by Audrey Snyder in three parts.
Thank you.
crossing. It's by S.A. M. Barnwell. It is in five parts, S-S-A-T-B.
Large chorus. This is one chorus in the school. Do you rehearse?
We normally have about 160 or 70, but we don't have them all here today.
Okay. Do you rehearse in sections?
We do sectionals and we do an all-call, and we do have a class daily
for most of them.
Wonderful. I'll tell you, one thing I was really impressed with, and you don't, maybe you do know how hard this is. Did you ever talk about singing softly?
No, of course you do, because you do it well. Nothing that you do well ever happens by accident. I've learned that. It happens with hard work. It's like your parents come and they see your concerts and it's wonderful and beautiful, but they see the finished product and they don't see how many times your teacher said, be quiet here, be quiet. It has to be softer here, come on, beautiful sound. So I think one of the things that this course does very well, especially with this many kids, and I can tell you, I know what it's like. You put a lot of students together and you get the sense of power and you can do anything and you always over-sing, but this group does not. Okay? So one thing I'm very impressed with is your ability to pull back and say, look, I want to sing out my best, I love singing, but I can still get the dynamic that's written in the music, and the dynamic is the musical volume, right? Dynamics, we know that word. And I was very impressed with that. I really want to work with you on one basic thing today, and it's going to be how to maybe sound a little bit older than you are, all right? Let's see if we can leave here sounding a year older. Everyone has to be a year old, okay? Got it? So the first thing I want to start with is we're going to do maybe, it really doesn't matter what song we pick, but I want to start with a quick little warm-up, ready? You ever seen the movie Home Alone?
Yes!
You know the warm-up I'm going to do?
No.
Okay, because if I'm telling you something you already know, then I'll just be quiet. But what's happening right now is you sing so beautifully on many things. I want to see if we can get a tall sound. So what happens, it's almost this easy. Any of you ever sing Happy Birthday to your friends in the cafeteria?
Oh. Yes. Yes.
It's god-awful, isn't it?
Yes.
Okay, so here's what goes on. The reason it's so awful is because everyone's smiling and they're bobbing the maneuver together. Now, here's the trick. You need, while you do the Home Alone Kid maneuver, it's not just a matter of having a round mouth that's tall. You have to have space in your mouth. Your mouth is where you resonate sound and where you produce sound. I want you to pretend, this is going to be painful, that there is a toothpick standing straight up in your mouth. Yep, just pretend with a happy face that that's happening. Home Alone Kid, ready, and. And we're going to do something called a breath and sigh. Here we go. Breath and sigh, have you done that before? All right, we are going to Home Alone Kid. We have some air in the mouth, so you can feel it in the back of your throat. Oh, not open enough, some of you not open enough. You should feel cool air in the back of your throat when your lungs are open. Now repeat after me. Oh! Ready, and.
Oh!
Boys can do it too. Boys can do it too for sure. Boys can get high as high as the girls. Again, here we go. Thank you very much. Open up. Breath and sigh, tall vowel. Ready, and.
Oh!
So this is kind of silly stuff I'm having you do, but I want to see if we can get, apply this tall, beautiful sound into a song you sing. And I almost don't care what song it is. So how about we just take a Red, Red Rose. Can we do that, please? So here we go. Every song begins with silence, ready to go.
Bless you.
Thank you.
Is this a cappella, or are you going?
Oh, no, we just, director prefers to give a pitch beforehand.
Okay.
Yeah.
Why don't you just start it? You,
okay.
You do the tempo, you know what? I want you to be so happy with how you're singing that. First thing is, how do you do a D? Tip of the tongue in front of the mouth, right? D's and T's, final D's and final T's in pieces are the hardest consonants to get. And I know, once again, they will never come out right by accident. If it comes out right, it's because you worked hard to get it. So, I want to get the tip of the tongue in front of the mouth, okay? Have you ever heard that tip of the tongue in front of the mouth? The other D, so here we go. Red.
Red.
Red. Red.
So we're doing what's called a little shadow. A little shadow, we're putting this like A after the D. Red.
Red.
Okay, now when you sing it, you're not going to do that much A, of course, right? The main vowel I want you to get is an O. And the way you produce an O is this. Home Alone Kid, ready? Now, if you, that's your ah, keep your ah without the hands, the ah. Tall toothpick, okay? An O has more lift. So a little bit more lift for the O. Here, I'm going to go from A to O. Here it is. A. Now O.
O.
When you sing Rose, You're going to have your O as tall as you can with that shape, and it's going to be the most beautiful volley you ever sound. So this is what I want, ready? We're going to go and do just that much, and we're going to get that O, if nothing else, tall and rich and gorgeous, and you'll be so proud. We'll be talking while you're on the rides of terror later, how good that O of rolls is. You ready? Can we, how about with a measure before? Can we measure before?
Of course.
Thank you. If you got rose that beautiful, why can't we get love that beautiful? Love. Ah, this is easy. Ah is way, thank you. Ah is way better than oh. Way easier. All you have to do is the Home Alone kid and swell in that note love. Oh my love. This for me means swell. Love and rose is going to be gorgeous, and you sound a year older. I already hear it creeping in. You're about a half year older right now. You get love and you get rose gorgeous. I hear a year older. Okay? Get to drive. Okay, how about a measure before? Better D on red. Okay, both reds have to have perfect D's, tall vowels, and then I'm done. You're off to the park. So please work. Respond so well with direction. Same spot.
Wonderful teaching going on here, and a good response to that teaching for middle school chorus is just a wonderful, wonderful job, and you're to be commended. Nice job, kids. We gave you a nice gold medal today.
Thank you.
on the Abraham Lincoln speech of the same name. Thanks very much.
Thank you.
conductor tells you to pull up the barrel or push in and whatever you have to do, and you do that, you pull it out, you're playing in tune. I think you use a tuner, is that right? You use one of the
No, actually, we don't. Well, I'm trying to get them to do my ear.
Yeah, okay. And those little tuners are just, they're not that expensive, okay? But they tell you exactly when you're in tune, because the needle will point right to the center. So if it tells you that you're sharp or flat, you pull out, and you're set, take your pencil and mark it on your barrel. For clarinets, remember how far you push out if you pull out the barrel. Flutes, remember how far you pull out and so forth. And the next day, believe it or not, folks, trombones, where your slides come out, the next day it's going to be just about the same. 99% is going to be in the same place. So start with that each day, okay? Always listen to each other, okay? When you warm up, place your scales together just to get started, okay? So intonation is a big factor. The balance of blend generally is very good. What do I mean by balance? Balance means that the drums, the percussion, are balancing with the rest of you. Because believe it or not, the percussion section is the only section in the band or orchestra that can play louder than anybody else. I mean, if you give a big whack on that bass drum, folks, and you guys are playing double forte, I'm telling you, and you can trust me, he's gonna sound loud. We won't even hear you because of that. But the percussion section can also play softer than anybody else. Okay? Why is that? Our sound is produced by what?
Air.
Okay? We have to control the air, whether we play loud or soft or so forth. Okay? That's a problem for us. Okay? But their pitch sound is controlled by touch. Just like a piano. Piano's a percussion instrument. It's because we touch it. And that's what piano means. Piano, the real term for it is pianoforte. Think the inside of your mouth is being open. Your oral cavity is being this way, like yawning with your mouth closed. So you relax. And you just breathe like normally. And you're kind of talking right now. Play the instruments. Okay? So that's one thing I want. Let me just take a couple of things here. Let's take the house invited just for a second. Now, low brass, when you come in here, right at the third bar, separate that half note from the next sound. So you're going da, 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 da. Separate that sound. Don't run it together. Just because it's soft, don't run it together. Separate it. Okay, let's try that. Right at the beginning. One, two, everybody, and.
Involved in music, wonderful to see. So many parents involved and chaperones, that's wonderful to see too. We're very happy to award you a gold medal.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Nice job, guys.
Thank you. Bye.